Professor Dawkins, can you give an example of a mutation or a evolutionary process that can be shown to increase the amount of information in the genome?
There's a popular misunderstanding of evolution which says that fish turned into reptiles and reptiles turned into mammals, and so somehow we ought to be able to look around the world today and look at our ancestors. We ought to be able to see the intermediates between fish and reptiles and between reptiles and mammals. We ought to be able to see fish kind of on the way to becoming reptiles. But of course that's not the way it is at all. Fish are modern animals. They're just as modern as we are. They're descended from ancestors, which we're descended from. Way back 300 million years ago, there would have been an ancestor, which was the ancestor of modern fish and the ancestor of modern humans. And that ancestor, if you could have been there then, you could have seen the first steps towards a fish, say, coming out onto the land and becoming... becoming something like an amphibian. But that was a long time ago. You wouldn't expect to see that today.
Professor Dawkins, I guess what you meant to say was no.
Ah!